when I was writing these poems, I began at one stage to be fascinated by the hero. And a sense was like that Yeats, in our century, he celebrated a hero like Cuchulainn. When he went back, when he climbed through the kind of Hadrian's Wall between Anglo-Ireland and Celtic Ireland, when he walked through that Hadrian's Wall or that Offa's Dyke and went out into the Celtic world, he celebrated a hero like Cuchulainn. Now, it seems to me that the 20th century, no, that somehow or other a hero like Cuchulainn isn't what we need. We need another kind of hero altogether. And so I wrote three poems about one called Concaith Cathach, one about Faust, and one about the Wandering Jew. And in these, I'm trying to explore, I'm trying to imagine another kind of heroism altogether. And basically, the heroism that I'm imagining in Faust, in the particular poem now, which you don't have, but I have here in front of me, the particular kind of heroism that I'm imagining here is the person in whom the greatest integration of all that we inwardly are has taken place. I mean, a hero now isn't someone who goes and fights the sea. It isn't a hero now isn't someone who goes and comes home with the greatest number of enemy heads on the chariot. The hero now is not someone who wields a sword. When I talked earlier about the sanctity of inclusion, I was talking there about someone who puts up his sword and, you know, lets nature happen to him. Like little Sarah, she didn't take a sword to the horse in the door. She eased the tail aside and walked under. And in some sense, she integrated there, as we might imagine it, integrated animal nature in her. So could I just read this poem, Faust? Faust is in his study, the normal place where you'd meet Faust, you know. We'd meet him in Marlowe's Faust and in Goethe's Faust. I mean, he's in his study. Now he's in his study. So can I just read it to you? Look again at your feet, Faust. Your house smells like a stable. The sea-green horse and the high half-hoof of stars you saw must be conjured tonight from your table. But the demons we dream of no longer desire us, and the stakes we embraced at our birth burn out. In the books she is Venus, and the flesh is the virus that holds every cell like a bit in its mouth. And neighing for the beast, you must migrate through your dream in the shade of the carnal tree. Aquarius walks in the desert towards you, and archangels grow wild at the edge of the sea.